Well, we're going to give ourselves over to prayer here. And to do that, what we're going to be doing tonight is we're going to be getting into groups around you. So some of you are going to have to just go to the persons next to you or nearest to you. Maybe need to cross over here or there. But get into small groups. I mean, just try to keep it groups of 2 to 4 people, if you would, please. And then we're actually going to break up a couple of times. We're actually not going to, but we'll have individuals that we've selected to pray for certain things as well. I made a comment in one of the prayer emails I sent out this week that we pray for others, but we plead for our children. And I think there's a lot of truth to that. It would be nice if we had the same passion for all of the things we're about to pray for tonight as we do when we pray for our loved ones. And I think there is the possibility that we can have that and even ask God for that. The very first thing we're going to do is get into groups, and we're going to be praying. Our theme here is humility, praise, and thankfulness to God. And you'll see a list of things to be praying for in your group: soul saved, finances, our building project, lives to be changed, joy, God's blessing. This is what I would like you to do. Get into groups, and every one of you mention somebody who needs to be saved in your life, and they should be prayed for by somebody else. And every one of you mention someone whose life needs to be changed that's close to you. And then pray around the other things. We've got 5 minutes, and so let's gather around and let's pray. As we wrap it up here, we're going to switch to our children's ministry. The Lord Jesus said that, let the little children come to me. Don't forbid them, for of such is the kingdom of God. And so we have a whole ministry around our children, and we call it Shine. It's going on right now, so it's a good time to pray for them and to pray for their leadership and just a number of things. In fact, I've asked Corey Pearson and Chris Hay to pray for our children's ministry. And I'm going to start with Corey, if you would start us off in that prayer. And then when you're done, Chris will pray. And let's all go to prayer over our Shine Children's Ministry.
Our children before you this evening. And I want to lift up Chad Fincham and the other Shine workers. Father, we are so grateful for the ministry that they play in our kids' lives. And what a just an invaluable resource to have the Shine just program to be building into our kids' lives as sort of a supplement to what we are trying to do with our kids. And so give us a sense of appreciation and gratitude for all the work that goes into those efforts. And just ask that you would be at work in and around the lives of those leaders, that they would have a real impact in our kids' lives as well. Want to pray also for us as parents. What a humbling task to be building into our kids' lives. And I think each one of us would be very honest in saying that we fall short in so many ways. And so I pray that you would be continuing to work in our lives, and that we would be continuing to grow in our walk with you. And secondly, and probably more important, I pray that you would be working around our shortcomings, and that you'd be reaching into our kids' lives and hearts, and that they would see a reality of our faith, not a perfection, but a reality of our faith that is real to them, and that is mirrored in their lives then from what they see in ours. And so we just ask that your Holy Spirit would be working in a great, great way in the lives of us, our teachers in Shine, and also our kids. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Father, as we continue in prayer, I just want to pray for those kids that do know you, and that those that are in the public arena, that you would use them through whatever way you see fit to share the gospel, not so much through words, but through their actions and just how they live their lives at school, and that they would stand for you, because we know that the public arena is becoming increasingly hostile towards you, Lord, and so that means they're going to be hostile towards us. So give these young kids courage and give them honesty, Lord, that I think that is probably the best thought that we can have. So we just pray for these young kids that their friends would be impacted by their lives, by their testimonies. And again, we pray for those that don't know you, that they would come to know you soon, Lord. And we think of salvation experiences around here at Sailorville. And just this afternoon, hearing about a guy that Chris and I worked with, a friend of his just got saved through another guy here at church. Just seeing you work through this church is amazing. It's humbling, Lord. Thank you for using us. I say thank you, Lord, for continuing to use me in spite of myself, and I mean that. So we just continue to ask for opportunities. Help us to be faithful. Help us not to shrink back, to be shy, but to go forth boldly with the gospel, but to do it in love, Lord. Help us. There are so many people around that are not believers that think that we hate them because we are Christians. Help us to show them love like you did, Christ. Help us to remember to love these people, love them right to you. So just help us in that area. And then, Father, I think of our building project. Lord, we have lacked in, well, not lacked, but we've tried hard to understand what direction you want us to take. And you know our needs, Lord, but we need it, Lord. We need room, and we're thankful for this problem. So we pray that you would give us wisdom, give us direction, give us finances to do this building project, and help us to use it to glorify you, to see souls come to you through the many ministries that I know would be involved in this building project. And we just thank you for this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thanks, Corey. Thanks, Chris. Youth ministry is one of the most dynamic and yet sometimes thankless and difficult. It has everything. It has joys and difficulty and every. And here we got youth right over here tonight wrapped into it. I have been involved in youth ministry as well as virtually every other pastoral ministry. But I loved working with youth years ago. But now I'm grateful somebody else is doing it, and it's Brad Posley, and we're grateful to him. Just the other day, a woman visiting our church through a series of circumstances came to know Christ as her Savior, and her son, through the ministry of Brad, came to know Christ as his Savior just the other day. But pray for this ministry. We're going to get into groups to do that. It's all listed right here. I want you to look at that list. They got a missions trip coming up. With the situation with the Bible College, disfellowshipping with us, we're going to have some holes to fill. So we're going to have new leadership positions that need to be filled. Pray about those, please. And just for unity and growth, just like it says here, and that some of these young people who don't know Jesus as their Savior will come to Christ, that God will raise up some of these young people to love Jesus, not just love him, but serve him, maybe even the call of ministry in their life, right out of our youth. How awesome would that be? So let's be fervent about this in this group. In this prayer time, we got 5 minutes. Let's give yourself to the youth ministry, beginning with Pastor Brad. All right. Well, thank you for praying for our youth ministry tonight. And now we've designated a couple of individuals to pray for this next category, which is adults. That's us, so you'll want to pay special attention to this one, huh? So we're talking about our singles ministry, men's and women's, not just ministry, but the men and women in our church as husbands, as wives, as fathers, mothers, leaders, etc. And our cell groups, vital part of our church ministry is our cell groups, as you know. And our Rise Up ministry, which doesn't get a ton of notoriety, but we have tons of people who are, not tons, but lots of people that are working over there, and it just continues to be a growing ministry, running concurrent with our second service, and then our seniors ministry. And I mentioned this morning, I'm very grateful for Arlen Thorson and the work that he's doing there, and he's actually going to be one of the guys that pray. So Norm Borst is going to pray if you'd start us off, and then Arlen, would you conclude? Let's put all of our hearts through and ears to these prayers as we bring our adult ministry before the Lord.
Father, as we think this evening of our 128 ministry, I think of Paul and Steph as they head this ministry up. I pray that you would just guide and direct in their hearts and lives and give them wisdom as they direct that ministry. We do think of our singles and career. They do face a lot of decisions during this time in their life, and I pray that it concerns their careers and their ministry and their maybe marriage and all the decisions that face them. I pray that you would give them real wisdom and strength, and that they would remember that you are there for them. This might be a time that they maybe at times feel lonely. We just pray that you would fill that loneliness in their hearts and in their lives. We thank you for them. We just pray that you would give them guidance. And we think of the men here in our local church and even in our church plants that, Father, we need men today that will step up and be spiritual leaders in their homes and in their churches. And I just pray that all of us men would be found, first of all, knowing Christ as our personal Savior. That's the main thing. And then as we endeavor to serve you in the way you'd have us to be men of integrity, to be receptive to your leading of the Holy Spirit. And we just pray that we would take the leadership responsibilities, not maybe as an iron-handed military way, but in a humble and just leading with integrity. And then also, as we think of the women in our church, as wives and mothers, first of all, we thank you for godly wives. And I'm afraid we, as men, maybe take them for granted quite often. So we do thank you for them. And they face a lot, Father, this day and age as they try to juggle children's activities and maybe a job and different things of trying to make the grocery stretch a little further and all these things, Lord, that bombard them. We just pray that you'd give them real strength and wisdom as they lead their families, their children, and in a lot of times in their teaching of the children and the nourishing. We thank you for them. Just strengthen, guide, and direct each one, we pray in Christ's name. Amen.
Gracious Father, we thank you for these next three groups. Father, I would like to thank you for the foresight that you gave our church in the past for supporting these, for initiating them, for getting them off the ground. Father, I think of the cell groups and how a little bit controversial, no, a whole lot controversial they were at the very beginning, but how humbling it has been for those of us that were resistant to it to see how effective the cell groups have reached out to so many people. I believe it's over 500 people. And Father, I thank you for not only these groups and not only these meetings and not only these studies, but for the lives that are being touched and changed within these groups, the Christian friendships that are being developed, the mentoring situations, the discipleship experiences that have all come out of these smaller groups, more intimate meetings. And I pray that you would continue to bless us, continue to bless Abe as he leads this group. And Lord, we pray that you would give him wisdom in terms of how to best organize it. Father, I thank you for Rise Up And I don't know how to say thank you, Father, for the vision that you have given Ross and his crew, and the passion that you have given them to reach the challenged ones. And Lord, I'm so thankful for the growth that you have given that ministry. And I would ask that you would continue to bless, continue to open doors with various group homes, with various individuals, with various caretakers, and that you would allow more and more people to be to come under that ministry. And I do pray a special blessing on those folks who are doing such a wonderful job in leading that Rise Up group. And Father, selfishly, I thank you for the seniors. I thank you for the numbers there. I thank you for opportunities to reach beyond the circle of this church. I thank you for the many people in the seniors group that are so unselfishly giving of themselves to others, and serving others and helping others, and that's at all ages. I thank you for the challenges and encouragements that we have all received from everyone in there. And I cannot skip over our matriarch, Ellen, at this time, and how encouraging she is. Her ministry continues to baffle us, continues to amaze us, and continues to humble us as to how the Lord continues to work in her life. And I pray that you would bless each of these people, from cell groups to Rise Up to seniors, and continue to help us to hold up your name high above everything else. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, Arlen. Arguably, the heartbeat of our church has been gospel ministry, and it really is. And that's the next item on our agenda. I asked you to pray for somebody earlier, but I'm going to have Chuck start us off, but I want you to turn towards your groups right now. You'll see all these things that we want to be praying about, but I want you to include your prayers for Chuck, because Chuck's passion is not just to be a personal evangelist. About 4 or 5 years ago, God put a great burden on Chuck's heart to mentor people to be evangelists. And God has answered that prayer. And may he multiply that prayer. That's one way you can pray for him, that he will be effective in his outreach and the multiplication of his ministry. We got Easter services coming this week. We've got our Good Friday service, which is arguably every bit and maybe more evangelistic than the Easter service itself, even though they're both very gospel-centered. Pray about those things. But I've asked Chuck to turn to your groups right now, and Chuck, begin and start us in prayer, and then after he's done praying, you pick it up with this list.
Father, thank you for tonight. And this, to us, is one of the most exciting weeks of the entire year, if not the most exciting. We get to celebrate the passion of our Lord and his resurrection. And that's what's changed every person in this room that has embraced it. So we, with deep thanksgiving, come to you and say, thank you so much. But we also know you'd like to reach far more than the people that are there in this room. Father, I would guess that every single one of us right now have people in our mind that we would long to be at the Easter service here, if not here, at least to watch it. So, Father, I pray this week now, as we have already invited a number of people, there may be other people that we need to invite that we've forgotten. Bring those people to our minds. Allow us to talk with numbers of people this week inviting them to service, sharing the good news of Christ. So, Father, we pray that we would have great numbers that would come to the services both on Friday and on Sunday. Yet even though we have the great numbers, we know that's not it. Fathers, we read the book of Acts, and as it's been opened to us, even in these last Sundays, we understand that unless the Holy Spirit comes in power, nothing is going to happen here. We're so dependent upon that because we can't change anybody. But you do, and you long to use your word to change lives and to use testimonies that we're going to hear on Easter Sunday here. I already pray for those, as I've heard others already praying. My other prayer is that you would not let us forget to lift these services up to you daily, hourly, just asking that you would pour out your richest blessing on this service, on these services. And I pray for Pastor Pat as he meditates. I pray for the musicians that you would help them in their practice as they get ready. Father, I just pray that you would remind all of us throughout this week to pour out our hearts for this service, for this week. And Father, when it's done, we would be able to look back and say, God, you've done a wonderful work here. And so that's our prayer, that you would give us one of the greatest weeks that we've had in the history of our church. And Father, I want to pray for our church plants as well, as they're doing the very same thing. And Father, some numbers of people have fasted for the very first time last week. Maybe we should be fasting again this week. You burden our hearts. And Father, may you richly bless as we seek to make your gospel known so that your name would be glorified. This we ask in your Son's name.
In 2 Corinthians 11, the Apostle Paul listed all these things that he had endured. And it's just an overwhelming list of things. And he could stop short of the verse I'm about to quote to you, and you would still be overwhelmed with the list. But he concludes it almost as an addendum. He says, besides all this, my care, or another way to put it, my deep concern for all the churches. That line there illustrates just a little bit what pastoral ministry is like. And it's not possible to really share with you all the burdens that we have to, that we pick up. And of course, the joys offset those burdens as well. But representing all the pastoral staff, I thank you for your prayers. You have no idea how meaningful it is to me when I hear someone say, I pray for you on a regular basis, or I pray for you every day. And this next segment, we are dedicating to prayers for the pastoral staff and the deacons who are helping as servant leaders, as we talked about this morning in the church. And I've asked a couple of individuals to pray for that. Who are the? Randy Kleinfelder is one. And who is the other one? Dick. So Dick is going to start us off praying for the pastors, and Randy will conclude with a prayer for our deacons and staff here at Sailorville. So let's go to prayer, shall we?
Heavenly Father, I just am very thankful tonight for our pastors. I've been in church all my life. I've seen some good pastors, but I've never experienced the blessings that we're experiencing here at Sailorville as we are right now. And I think that's because of the faithfulness of the men that you've sent to us. And I just want to uphold them tonight. I want to pray for Pat, for Kevin, for Abe, for Brad, for Chuck, and for Paul. They have an awesome responsibility to uphold your word, to be faithful to it, to lead us. And Lord, it seems to me that that's happening. I pray, Lord, that you will grant them all the wisdom and discernment that they need to carry out this job. I know Satan would love to get in here and bring these men down, cause great dissension in this place. But Lord, as long as we're faithful to you, I know you'll bless, and that will not happen. And I just pray, Lord, that these men will continually seek your will and follow your word and be faithful to it. And I know the blessings will continue. I've been reading in 1 and 2 Samuel and 1 and 2 Kings how God continually promised Israel and the kings, if they would just follow him, the blessings that would happen. And when they did, they were blessed. And when they didn't, they fell. So God, I pray that, that your word will be utmost in this place, that our leadership will continually follow and worship you and follow your word. And Lord, we as a people, may we uphold them in prayer constantly and follow them. As long as they're following you, I pray we will be faithful to follow their leadership. And I'll just again thank you for them. And Lord, I just want to especially mention Kevin tonight. I've sat under his leadership and his areas of responsibility. I've seen his wisdom and his guidance. I know of many people that have been helped by his counseling, and for a time he's been set aside. But God, it is our desire that you restore him, and that he will be able to come back and serve you in the manner in which he's accustomed to serving you, and maybe even be able to be better at it because of what he's gone through. So, Lord, if it is in your will to raise him up, we pray that is what will happen. I also want to especially mention Pat tonight, Lord, and the responsibility he has over this whole place under your leadership. Guide him, Lord, direct him, bless him, and protect him and all these men and their families. And we'll just thank you in Christ's name.
And, Lord, we continue on in this prayer of thankfulness for the church, your church, Lord, the body of Christ. And Lord, as pastors spoken to us even about we being the pillars holding up the truth, and yet, Lord, the body of Christ has many parts. Dick has just prayed for our pastors, and Lord, they lead us in many great ways, and we're thankful for that. And yet we know there's many, many areas of the church that require many people and many servants for you. Lord, I thank you for the staff that you've given here, and a spirit of unity and a spirit of joy that is evident in their life. From Lisa, who's just going all the time, and yet with a joyful spirit, to Stu, who has faithfully served here, and we thank you for his ministry in that way, and Chad as well, as he works diligently with the youth that we've prayed about. We just thank you for his faithfulness and for how you've plugged him in this ministry in a great way. Lord, we thank you for Doug. And Lord, again, just talking to someone this morning that, how did you hear about Sayreville? I asked them. It was through the web, and technology is a big part of our world. And I'm thankful that we can use technology, Lord, to proclaim the good news of Christ here at Sayreville. And I pray you continue to bless Doug and his role, and continue to give him wisdom and expanding in even greater ways. Lord, for Tom and his many areas of service, Lord, what a willing spirit you've given him. We thank you for him. And I know Liz is here during the week, and I'm thankful for her gifts, her ability to serve and to help out as needed. And then as Arlen serves in this vital role with our seniors, Lord, we thank you for him. And trust you give these individuals wisdom, give them a spirit of unity, help them to fall under the authorities that they have here at church. And Lord, that you would continue to bless the ministries here. And then, Lord, we're thankful for, even as Pastor preached about a little bit this morning, just the area of deacons and the 10 men that we have selected, Lord, for their godly character. Lord, I pray that you would keep these men in your word, that you would continue to provide unity in their own families. And, Lord, they've got many different areas, roles, as Pastor talked about, kicking up the dust. Lord, they're busy serving you, and we thank you for that. And Lord, help us as a congregation to encourage the staff and the deacons and our pastors. Help us to fall under their authority as well, and to keep them in our prayers, Lord, that you would keep them unified and give them wisdom as they deal with important areas of the church. And we know the gospel is utmost importance, Lord. But there's areas of finances, there's areas of just leadership responsibilities and tough decisions that need to be made. And I pray that you would be with our deacons as they meet, as they plan, as they pray, as they deal with some ugly issues, Lord. You're dealing with people, you're dealing with problems, and I know that you would give them wisdom as they work through these issues, and I pray that you'd give them a spirit of unity as you have with our pastoral staff as well. And Lord, we thank you for their faithfulness. Help us, Lord, to be faithful in our prayers for them this week as well. Lord, in Christ's name I pray.
Will you just continue in prayer with me? Our Father, we are so grateful that we can bring all of these requests before you individually, as groups, and corporately. Even as Randy just finished praying, Lord, he himself, having been a deacon for many years and having those qualifications as well, he understands the burden of leadership, and we're grateful, Lord. I personally am very grateful for the deacons in our church, but I too am grateful for our shine teachers and our ushers and our greeters, and I thank you for our women's ministries and men's ministries, those working back in the coffee cove and just making many hands, making light work all over the place. Just thank you, Lord, for the ministry around this church. And yet, Lord, for all of our blessings and for all the encouragement and for people who are coming to know Christ. And I think of the Easter service coming up here, Lord, as has been prayed. I think of Jen and Lauren, who are going to be baptized this Easter. And I think of Stephanie and Tona, who are going to be baptized as well, and Eric. I pray that these baptisms, Lord, would just be crystal clear and would touch many hearts, and people's hearts would be, believers would be convicted who aren't living for you, and their hearts would be revived, and unsaved would be convicted, and they would turn to you and they would be saved. I pray, dear God, that your Holy Spirit would be working in our hearts and bring forth genuine revival, causing sin to flee, us to flee sin. Attitudes that are wrong and hurtful and divisive would go away. People that are alienated and at variance with one another would be reconciled, because humility has reigned and Christ has been Lord in the whole thing. I pray, Lord, that great things would happen, and we know that we are nothing without you. And without you, Lord Jesus, we can and will do nothing. We pray for our missionaries. Oh, God, help them. I know that I talked to Lucas Bear the other day, and he's led somebody to Christ. He was so happy, but he was yet so discouraged by what was going on in that church. There's so much sin. It's so rife down there. And he just needed to be encouraged. Encourage him. Encourage our missionaries, Lord. Encourage all those who faithfully uphold your word. Sweep around this world revival before your coming, Lord Jesus. And do come. Do come, Lord Jesus. And maybe our hearts be united with you, with one another, preaching that gospel as we go, even as they did in the earliest of days, that you might be pleased. And thank you for this time that we could spend in corporate prayer. And we pray these things in the name of Jesus. Amen. God bless you. Thanks for praying. Continue to pray throughout this week. Chuck mentioned fasting this week. Some of you, I'm not going to ask for a show of hands. That would defeat half the purpose now, wouldn't it? But I hope you had a great experience in fasting, and I would encourage you to consider it again this week as we move toward Easter. And if you do so, just pray like crazy for that Saturday or Friday prayer. And then, of course, Lord's Table and Good Friday, and then, of course, the Easter celebration. God bless you. You're dismissed. Have a great week.